The first thing we're going to do here is to bring the Fusion composition clip into the timeline and then directly to the Fusion page. Then we're going to pull in the text node as well as the background node. And then we're going to connect the text node to the background as the foreground. And then bring the merge node over to media out one. In the text node, the first thing we're going to do is to change the font style. And then we're going to write our text in the text box. And then bring up the size a little bit there as well. So, okay. Now the next thing we're going to do is to create that random text blur effect. And to do that, we're going to click into the text box and then right click and in the menu select follower. So this is going to open up the modifiers tab up top. And that's where we're going to make further changes to our text properties. So let's start by changing the delay setting to 2 frames. And then let's go to order. We're going to change that from automatic to random, but 1 by 1. You can also go with completely random, but we're gonna stick to 1 by 1 for now. Okay, let's move to shading, and then let's go to softness. For the X and Y settings, we're going to start by keyframing them, and then let's bring their values all the way up, and that's going to be 20, but you can also override it with something much higher, like 30, 40, if you want a much stronger text blur. All right, so once that is done, let's go ahead and move our playhead from 0 to, I would say, about 30. That's where we want the blur to sort of start to go away. So let's bring the X and Y all the way down. That will also automatically keyframe. So at this point, guys, we are pretty much done with our cinematic text blur effect. And that looks pretty good, right? So we're going to continue to polish this effect, but as far as workflow goes, we are pretty much done. Okay, so let's take it back to the Fusion page. Let's go to the text node, and then under modifiers tab, we're going to change the delay setting from positive 2 to negative 2, or negative any value. But the idea here, guys, is that we want only certain characters of the text to start out blurry instead of all the characters. And if you want the duration of this blur to last a little bit longer so that it's going to look softer, let's come back to the modifiers tab, and then let's go to shading, and then we're going to change so the keyframe where this blur is going to finish, which is 30 frames, we're going to change that to, I would say, 60. And so let's go ahead and set a keyframe there. Then let's go to the 30 frame and then get rid of the keyframes for X and Y. So now, as you guys can see, this blur is going to last much longer. It's going to look much softer. But once again, only certain characters of the text are going to start out blurry. So let's bring everything back to its original setting, but that's one type of effect that we can create. Another thing we can do to our effect here is to add a nice glow to it. So to do that, we're going to go to our glow setting, set a keyframe, and then we're going to just bring it up a little bit there. And then we're going to come to the 30th frame, bring the glow setting all the way down to 0. So now, as you can see, our effect not only has this nice blur to it, but also has this beautiful glow added on top of it. Another thing we can do is to add a nice fade in to everything else. So to do that, we're going to come to the opacity setting, set a keyframe there, and then bring our playhead over to the right a little bit. And then we're going to set another keyframe for our opacity setting. But let's come to the first keyframe, and we're going to actually have this start out at 0%. So now, as you can see, on top of the blur as well as the glow, we also have a very nice fading added to our effect here. So this is pretty much it, guys. We're going to take this back to the edit page, let everything render, and this is our cinematic text blur effect. As always, guys, I hope this tutorial helps, and I will see you next time.